Hi, everyone. Very excited today to kind of share with people here about my view of AI and also a little bit of research of how we are, you know, thinking about using LLM to simulate human. This is a joint work with two wonderful students, Leon and Tony from CS department, and also with my colleague, Hong Siuk. So I've been kind of fascinated by the following question since the beginning of ChatGPT, which is that, can we use LLM to simulate human? And I actually went ahead to kind of you know, try a little bit by myself. So I gave basically the ChatGPT a product, a random product from, you know, Amazon. And I asked ChatGPT, can you generate a person that actually purchased this product? And then this is the result. It actually makes sense. So ChatGPT said, you know, like a person called Emily, age 29, a marketing coordinator. She is potentially interested in this product. Her shopping habits is that, you know, she values pieces that are stylish yet comfortable, trendy yet budget-friendly fashion options. So apparently, you know, like ChatGPT understand the kind of the clothes and also the price and so on, right? And then I kind of change another product. This time is a blender, is a kind of premium blender. And then this time ChatGPT generated another person called Alex, you know, 34 years old, product manager at a tech corp. He likes to, you know, pay a premium for products that align with their commitment to healthy living. And if you look at the products and look at the person kind of, you know, generated, you're like, oh, this actually makes sense. And now, given those personas, actually I tried something even more, is that, okay, now I'm giving you a new set of products, right? And now, given these personas, now, will you, you know, which one you will be interested in? Will you be interested in any of them? And so I showed them three toothpaste, right? From a basic version to premium plus. Now, actually the results make sense. So I asked, you know, for Emily, which one she will choose. And ChatGPT tells me that, you know, Emily will likely choose the basic version because, you know, it's budget friendly and also, you know, fits her style. And then if you kind of ask Alex, and Alex actually will choose the premium plus one because, you know, like he likes kind of the healthy lifestyle and he can go with, you know, afford this premium plus. And I change other, you know, products and, the results actually you read is making sense, and in particular the reasoning, right? It explains why, you know, this person is interested in this. So I think this actually is super interesting to provide a lot of space for imagination, right? Because if you think about it, those persona, if you actually use it well, it can be widely deployed for, you know, like product testing, experimentation, right, product discovery, and to the place like you can use it to do political survey and a social science study. And actually there are already a lot of papers around this space showing how promising this idea is. And there are also a bunch of companies actually move ahead, actually deploy this. Olivia probably will expand much more on this topic. Now, so while I was kind of, you know, like studying and playing with this persona and also teaching it, one of my students actually come to me saying like, hey, Tianyi, if you kind of believe those persona can simulate human behavior, can we use it to predict the election? And I was not a big fan of, you know, any of the political stuff, but the last year, you know, like indeed it's kind of hard to predict the results. Now, obviously, we all know the results. So I said like, yeah, let's try it, right? So the way we are trying it is that, you know, like we firstly found the data from US Census, including a basic information about a person. And, you know, like we ask LLM to generate more information about this person, you know, from a basic information and to more kind of a freestyle description. And all those kind of following, you know, like this common practice, right, in the field. Now, given this persona, so I know there could be a bias, right, in this prediction, but this is what I get. I know it's going to be biased, but this is kind of a little bit like beyond my expectation. So I try to kind of make sense of it and try to make it more rigorous, right? Scientific curiosity. So we tried a different way of adding information to the persona, starting from adding basic information, and now to kind of a more like personality, and finally to more kind of freestyle. And this is what we observe. So if you add more information to the LLM, you will get more biased. And this, the same thing happened for 2020 and 2016. And if you think about it, because LLM is biased, probably many people have already felt it, but this is a new type of bias because it's not about the simulation itself, it's about the generation. It's about the person you generate is actually biased. And we also try this for different models, across different ways of generating personas, across five different type of LLMs, using them kind of cross-checking each other, the phenomena is kind of consistent, right? If you are kind of adding more information to the person profile, the results becomes more biased. And then we are like, okay, maybe this, before kind of moving forward, we find that there is one outlier. There's one model that actually flipped the results.
Grok?
Yeah. Any other guess? So it's actually a model from Baidu.
Oh.
So I think this is super interesting, right? It's kind of showing you different training data, how different, maybe different ways of training the data will give you very different results that you can't actually predict. But I think what is more important is that those bias, if it's just for this one particular political question, that might be fine. But what my worry people is that there are many hidden bias you don't expect, you don't know before. So we actually tried a more rigorous study for 500 questions from a data set called Opinion QA, like covers a broad range of questions. And we'll do observe like a consistent kind of bias in many different topics. And I'm trying to show you a few examples. One example is this purchase behavior. So it turns out the LLM persona, they tend to prefer electric car instead of the gas car. Right? So if you are using those LLM to kind of evaluate your products, you might be kind of, you want to be aware of this bias. And another question, which I kind of find interesting, is that the kind of LLM generated persona, they prefer liberty, art, and humanities as a college major comparing to STEM. And we also tried a fun one, which is, which movie do you prefer to watch? La La Land versus Transformer. And can you predict which one LLM persona will prefer?
Transformer?
Because they are trained by Transformer. So turns out they actually like La La Land more. Maybe we have different ways to kind of explain this, but I find this phenomenon itself kind of like, worth kind of a careful, understanding, and be careful, right? So finally, I kind of want to show you just one glimpse for what kind of a persona the LLM actually generate. So this is a word cloud about those personas, and for Florida. And if you read those words, it actually all makes sense, right? Community, they like culture, they like life, they enjoy life. History, heritage. But in general, you can find that they are, one is not super diverse. There is some sense of a stereotype, and the two is also very positive, right? It's kind of how you will, promote a place, those words you will say. But it doesn't necessarily kind of reflect what people's true opinion. So I think as a summary is that, you know, LLM persona and also the persona simulation is a very promising idea. I really like it. You know, simulate kind of a human behavior. Eventually, we might be able to simulate the whole society. But we also want to be very careful about how to sort of calibrate those persona to match you know, our reality. Because in some sense, the LLM is a prior, right? It learned from all the internet data. But how to kind of use that prior to kind of you know, produce value for you, you have to calibrate. And I think that's kind of what I learned. With that, I'm going to finish this talk and thank you. Thank you for listening.
Another question. So when you say biased, do you mean wrong or like biased in the...
Yeah, so exactly. So when we say biased, so we need a ground truth, right? I think for kind of an election, you have a ground truth. For purchase behavior, actually, you don't have a ground truth. But you do observe a trend, right? And then there's a question, you know, which way of generating persona actually reflects the reality? I think this kind of phenomenon here showing that, you know, like it's an, you know, you need to be careful about how you are going to generate them, because each different way may lead to a completely different results, and that will cause, you know, impact to your decision. So, you know, always remember to calibrate, ask, you know, whether the simulation and the persona profile itself match your customers. That's important.
Okay.
Yes.
Thanks very much for the talk. So my question is, when you are simulating the LLM persona, have you considered about the interaction between the personas that might contribute to the personality of individual, or that's more like a group behavior kind of simulation?
So let me kind of confirm your question here. You're asking, have I tried to kind of make those LLM interact with each other?
Yeah.
And you might observe interesting phenomena, also interesting bias from it.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
I completely agree. And so in this particular project, we didn't try, but there is another kind of project we are doing right now, which is sort of, if you imagine nowadays, you know, if you want to find a job, you will submit your CV, right? Very likely you ask ChatGPT to help you, you know, like polish it a little bit. On the other hand, you know, for those company, they are also using AI, another ChatGPT, to kind of screen your profile. And in the end of the day, that's the interaction across, you know, AI agents. And in this kind of a world, you know, what behavior will emerge? I think that's a super interesting question. And I do know a few studies actually from even our speakers today in this area. And I personally kind of feel like in particular, the bias, right, in those settings, it's hard to control now, right? For one LLM, maybe it's easy to evaluate and to test, but now if you have multiple LLMs, that question becomes even more important. And I personally feel like that's a very interesting direction to explore.
Thank you very much.